Welcome. I'm here at Manassas Beach State Park on like 60 degree end of November day. Quite overcast, but plenty of sun coming through. Not too much wind. A lot of people out and about moving, which is pretty inspiring. We're gonna do some Nedjatuan stepping, footwork, legwork practice. I'm not going to call it a drill. It's going to vary a lot. And so I'm going to just start by carrying my weight in one leg. So I shift to one leg, and that allows me to place the other leg. What I want to watch out for is that when I shift, I don't lean. I simply levelly move my hips and everything above them over one leg. There's no cantilever, there's no lean, there's no kick out of the hips where they don't stay level, and therefore no strain on the knee or ankle or a variety of other joints, no strain in the lower back, just a shift. Now I'm starting with my feet together, so there's not much shift, a few inches. Okay. Shift. And I have a bent leg, and I'm going to lift the other heel. And I'm going to set that other heel where I want it. I'm going to step towards camera in this case. So I'll start again. Sink. So my knees are bent. Shift to one leg. Lift the heel. And set the heel down forward. Roll the foot to greet the earth with the sole of the foot. And then levelly shift the hips, being careful to place the newly weighted leg, place its knee over the ball of the foot. And then I can use the power of my other leg to move it where I want, or I can use this leg to straighten, sort of lift, change my altitude to free the other leg. And in this case, I'll just put it right here. I have the stick here, which is pretty perpendicular to the view of the camera. So if we need to reference something with the footwork, we're going to have that. That's why I have that piece of cedar there. Just hopefully a visible line for you. So sink, shift levelly, float the heel. Set the heel forward or to the side, wherever it's going to go. When I set that heel forward, I want to make sure that this knee doesn't drift in. So the monitoring that I want to do is in the weighted knee. So I'm sinking, I have two bent knees, shift to weight, in this case on my right leg. Monitor that knee. Monitor that knee. That knee doesn't change. It doesn't bend more. It doesn't bend less. It doesn't drift medial or lateral. It stays exactly where it is. If, for example, I stepped quite far here, that knee would have to go somewhere. So sometimes the knee moves because it's encouraged to move because of a different choice you've made. So if I make a poor choice and then I decide not to move the knee, something has to give. I'm trying not to move the knee, but I'm demanding that it must, you know, physics. So think small, small step. Place the heel, small step. Roll the sole to greet the earth. Then carry the hips from one foot to the other foot. And that other foot has a knee over the ball of the foot, a bent leg, and this one I can feel is able to unpeel. If I've stepped very far here, I'll do it this side too. If I've stepped very far, by the time I shift forward, not only is this ready to unpeel, but it might be unpeeling. And I would say that that's over far, over long of a step. Sometimes that happens because our kind of eyes are too big for our stomach, right? We're a little too ambitious. So draw forward. From here, Raise the level of the head top, straighten the leg to come up. Now in this case, I have both my feet forward again. So saddle, shift, float the heel. I'll just step forward again as I'm in this direction here. Roll the sole, greet the earth, feel, listen, connect, communicate. Often that means quiet the mind, be patient with brain, then levelly move the hips until we find the knee over the ball of the foot and the weight over the foot itself. And then I can stand. Here I am again. In this case, I'm going to step back towards camera. So as I do that, I just want to monitor that knee. Heel, roll the sole. Shift, place the knee where it goes. And stand up, or just recover the leg with the leg's own muscular functions and return the leg. Now, I'll do it in profile again. If I step out here, and when it's time to bring this leg, if I have to bring the rooster shape, the breast forward, or the head forward, the ram shape, or if I find myself needing to do it fast because I kind of canted myself and pendulumed my leg, these are all signs that I've stepped a little too far for my abilities now to do this in an internal arts manner. So stand and recover. Now I continually have been recovering to our starting position, but I could certainly blend a few of these together so that as I stand here, I just start my next step. That's completely fine too. What I want to make sure is that if I stand, I don't stand up so far that my leg is straight or certainly not locked, but it's straighter, it's straightening here. And then step. Good. So the next level of this, the next element, the next degree, the next aspect, is that if I place my foot before I give it weight, I can turn my hip to aim the foot. All right. And you probably have at least 90 degrees of aim, but perhaps more, depends on your flexibility. So in this case, I stepped this direction, but I'm going to turn back to camera. So I turn my hip and then I roll the sole, greet the earth, meaning no weight, connect, listen, and then ask it something. In this case, ask it to bear your weight, ask the favor here, and then stand. In this case, I'm going to step towards camera-ish, but I'm going to open the hip, head back over to the west. Roll the sole, knee over the ball of the foot, and then in this case, I'm going to stand to recover this leg. And so just bend at the hip and the knee a tiny bit, and I let the leg hang. It wants to hang under the hip. I don't really have an awful lot of sense of pulling it and placing it. Right? So step, aim, right? So I choose a direction, roll the sole, greet the earth, then shift into the weight. I refer to as the meet and greet phase. Step, down, shift. So I kind of do this in every step in the internal arts. I unweight the leg if it needs unweighting. And if I happen to be planning to step my left foot, which doesn't have weight, that's not something I have to do, but it's still the first checklist. In this case, it's already done. Unweight the foot. Then I place the heel where I want it. In this case, the heel's already where I want it, but if it wasn't, I'd place it. Then I point the foot where I want it. If the foot's already pointed where I want it, great. Then I can roll the sole and bring the weight. So here, I don't have the foot pointing where I want it, so I'm going to actually do something there and come back. So over and over, I'm doing the same things. I'm taking the weight off. I'm placing the heel where I want it. And if it isn't, then I lift it and place it. Then I'm aiming the leg, which you'll see is the foot aiming. I'm turning the hip to where I want to go. Then I'm rolling the foot down. If it's already where I wanted to go, I don't actually turn it. Then I carry my weight over. And we want to make sure that the weight-bearing leg has a bent knee that doesn't move. So here I am shifting onto this leg, and I float the heel. And when I step it, see how my knee moved? That's not what I want. I want to step it with the knee not moving. And then when I turn this, I want to not move the knee. In this case, my knee kind of straightened and shifted back towards the outer side of my heel. That's incorrect. I need to monitor that, turn this leg. If I turned it out, I don't want the knee collapsing in. I want just to turn from the hip, roll. No change in the knee until the weight shifts, when I bring my weight to a well-laid foundation. So a nice practice with this is to do this with breathing. So inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, and so forth. So coordinating with the breath is really nice from the point of view of Qigong, but coordinating with the breath is really nice as well for slowing you down. And it isn't that you have to inhale on this and exhale on that. In fact, you can change it up, but the idea is to pair one element with one facet of the breath. So I can inhale, let the breath be full, exhale as I point, roll without the breath changing, inhale, etc. And I can just go inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now we've been talking about stepping with the heel, and that's the idea. As long as I can be relatively facing with my front where my heel goes, I want to step with my heel. So in this case, I've turned my body so I can step with my heel even though it's to the rear. And same thing on this side. If I didn't turn my trunk, that really is behind me now, right? That point sees the back of my shoulder. So it's the ball of the foot first, and then roll the foot, carry the weight. But if the point that I'm stepping to can see the front of the body or even just the side of the shoulders, the kind of the bounds of the front of the body, I want to step with the heel, then find the rest of the foot, meet the earth, carry the weight over, and so forth. So on the rare occasion that I'm stepping, I'll describe this in a moment, from this, had I been facing the way your camera's facing, if I'm stepping into this zone, what we might think of as the blind spot, then I'm going to step on the toes, right? The ball of the foot. And if I'm stepping into this wedge without turning the trunk, I'm also going to step with the toes, the ball of the foot. But I can reach all of this with the heel if I'm turning the trunk. So just to make sure that we're clear, that's fine, turning the trunk. This is going to be ball. Stepping more towards camera is going to be ball in either case, however I'm placing the foot. Similarly, I can turn the ball, then pivot the leg to set the heel down how I want. Stepping off to the side wouldn't be the ball, it'd be the heel. If I happen to turn here, step to the side, now it's really behind me, so I can do the ball. Okay? So just do a couple breaths as I just kind of meander. I'm going to stay into my lower center just to help me be present here from a center of gravity and a depth of breath point of view. I'm not particularly going anywhere. I'm just meandering, trying to kind of stay in front of the camera. Connect to the breath, connect to the lower aspects of the being, meaning the base and the physical, feet, the legs, the hips, the quad. All the while making sure that I don't lean, don't cantilever, don't bring the eyes off the horizon, don't shoot the chest out, don't reach the butt out, don't bring the belly forward as we step. Keeping good alignment so the body finds it most easeful to stay in vertical alignment and agreement with gravity. And I'm just kind of wandering and exploring. Sometimes I know where I'm headed. Sometimes I generally head to the camera, but then kind of just change just to have that practice. Often I'll do this, you know, holding a posture as I do my practice, and I might choose more challenging stances so that it's a stance practice as well as a stepping practice. Okay, so hopefully that was a bit helpful and maybe you enjoyed a pleasant view as well. I'm gonna cut it short because I have to go teach some lessons. Thank you.